The only constant is change. It's easy to get the impression that science is pretty much finished, that all the interesting problems have been solved, all the mysteries revealed, and all the exciting discoveries have been made. But have they? When you look at the history of science, it becomes crystal clear that there is no reason to believe that the sorts of change we've seen in the past can't happen in the future. Before 1543, people saw the Earth as the undisputed center of the universe. Copernicus showed them otherwise. People once thought the heavens were mystical, special. Newton showed us all, it worked like clockwork, that planets and apples followed the same laws, the same patterns. Chemists once saw combustion as the release of phlogiston. Lavoisier showed them elements combining with each other. And John Dalton made those elements into tiny spheres called atoms, of which everything is made. People were once confident that light was waves in the luminiferous ether, a stiff, massless fluid that permeated the universe. James Clerk Maxwell, who invented electromagnetic theory, wrote about the ether in the 1878 edition of Encyclopedia Britannica. He wrote, "Whatever difficulties we may have in forming a consistent idea of the constitution of the ether, there can be no doubt that the interplanetary and interstellar spaces are not empty, but are occupied by a material substance or body." But Einstein showed them they were wrong. Space was empty. That is, until quantum mechanics showed us that even vacuums are bubbling with an effervescence of particles popping into and out of existence. What's next? What are we wrong about? What possibilities could new answers open up? That's why we study history. It's easy to get the impression that there is no need for or possibility of change if all you see is the present. But when you see the past, you get a bird's eye view. You see patterns and trends. You see that we're not so different from our predecessors, our world not so different from theirs. You see history as a series of experiments in living, experiments you can learn from. And by studying the history of science, we can learn how science works. And we'll learn that it is highly unlikely that the changes are over. One can get the impression that change in current scientific knowledge is not only possible, it is highly probable. This is the subject of this course: the history and philosophy of science in 6 easy steps, online this summer.